Hi, this is Jessica from the Alice Ferguson Foundation. In this lesson, we're going to do an experiment to learn about nutrient pollution. So you've probably heard of the word nutrition before, which is a study of what we need to eat to grow and stay healthy. Nutrient pollution is when there's too much food for a certain organism in the ecosystem and it throws the ecosystem out of balance. Have you ever seen water with a thick green layer of algae on its surface? Like other plants, algae needs nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium in order to grow. These are the nutrients. When too much nitrogen or phosphorus in the water speeds up algae growth, this is called cultural eutrophication. Algae are found naturally in aquatic environments and are an essential part of the ecosystem. However, too much algae can harm aquatic ecosystems by preventing light from reaching other plants below the surface of the water. Without sunlight, plants will not survive and can no longer provide food or habitat for fish. Large algae blooms can also deplete oxygen levels in the water, which is harmful to fish. Sources of nitrogen and phosphorus pollution are fertilizers, animal waste, and sewage discharges. Now let's start our experiment to see which variables contribute to nutrient pollution. I have four containers, each with the same amount of water. Container 1 through 3 contains stream water, and container 4 contains distilled water. For this experiment, I'm using household plant fertilizer. If you take a look at the ingredients list, you will see nitrogen and phosphorus are two of the main ingredients. I'm going to add 100 milligrams of fertilizer to container 1, 2, and 4. I'm going to place this under each container to allow us to make observations about water clarity. For each container, write your day one observations on your data sheet. Now let's make observations about each of the containers. You may need to pause the video at each container to write your observations down. Container 1, stream water with 100 milligrams of fertilizer. Container 2, stream water with 100 milligrams of fertilizer. I'm going to place this container in a bag to block the sunlight. Container 3, stream water with no fertilizer added. Container 4, distilled water with 100 milligrams of fertilizer. Take a moment to write your hypothesis for each container on your data sheet. So it's been 10 days, so let's go take a look at what's developed and write your day 10 observations on your data sheet. Number 1 is stream water with 100 milligrams of fertilizer. Number 2 is stream water with 100 milligrams of fertilizer, which we placed in the bag. Number 3 is stream water with no fertilizer added. Number 4 is distilled water with 100 milligrams of fertilizer. To conclude our experiment, write your summary of changes on your data sheet and answer the discussion questions. Thanks for joining me for this experiment.